everyone, and welcome to the Modern Java course. One of the things that always made me jealous when looking at JavaScript was how easy it is to parse JSON in JavaScript. There are obviously downsides, but the amount of work we need to do is much greater, and some of it does feel like boilerplate. Thanks to the Manifold Project, Java has the option of leaping JavaScript and ease of parsing and processing such files. It is a revolutionary set of language extensions for Java. This is by far my favorite extension, but it's by no means the only one. Join me to never look at JSON in the same way ever again. Before I proceed, as usual, the code for this and the other videos in the series is available on my GitHub page. So check out this project, start it, and follow me on GitHub and here. Before we begin, the Manifold project is relatively young, but it's huge. Check out their website and Slack channel for more information and some of the amazing work done by Scott McKinney. To get started, we first need to install the Manifold plugin. This is currently only available for JetBrains IDEs. The project supports LTS releases of Java and the latest JDK 19, which is what I used. If you use a JDK that is in between or too new, you might be treading on untested waters. Manifold is comprised of multiple smaller projects, each offering a custom language extension. Today we will talk about one such extension, but there is much more. To demonstrate this project in simple terms, we'll use a simple Maven project. Manifold also works with Gradle too. I'll set the standard Maven project settings and create a new project. I wanted to show you that because it's important to understand there's no magic involved. Manifold feels a lot like magic once you start using it. So it's important to see it's just a plugin to Maven or Gradle coupled with an IDE plugin. Just in this case, is carrying a lot of weight, since it's an amazing project. The first thing to do is paste the current Manifold version from their website. We will use it for the dependencies that I will paste below. The dependencies follow a pretty standard formula. You can find the full list on their website. The first is the only one we really need for JSON, the manifold-json-rt dependency. The rest add support for YAML, XML, and CSV and follow a pretty obvious naming convention. Initially, we don't need those other dependencies, but spoiler alert, I will use them. Scrolling down, we can see the compilation plugin. This is generally the boilerplate that weaves Manifold into the bytecode and makes it seamless to us. It's mostly just boilerplate you copy from their website. So let's go right to the code. First, I will create a new directory to match the package I have for the code. When we want to read a JSON file, we usually have a sample JSON file or ideally a schema. I'll just place the sample JSON file that I have right here. It's a pretty simple JSON file with no frills or anything. It includes three strings, a Boolean value, and a nested list object. Let's go into the main class. I want to show you that I don't have a magical test class. The only classes matching test are completely unrelated. There's no pre-existing or generated code that implements test in any way, shape, or form. I have nothing up my sleeve. But now I'll click the Maven refresh button up on the right. Notice that there's a similar button in the Maven draw you can see on the right too. We can now see that a new test class suddenly appears, but if you will look at the code, no additional code was generated. This is a class that Manifold created dynamically out of thin air. If we change the JSON and refresh Maven, we will see everything updated seamlessly since no code is generated. The class contains many capabilities out of the box. I won't show everything, but the simplest and coolest thing is a Builder API that lets us construct a JSON object using Builder methods. Notice that this is Typesafe and works with Boolean or numeric values too. It seamlessly generated the nested object type, which we can add with nesting. That's pretty fantastic. With an invocation of build, a new JSON object is created seamlessly in Java. It's as easy as writing JavaScript, but is still 100% Typesafe and checked by the compiler. Code completion in the IDE works perfectly, as you can see here. Manifold compiled the JSON file as if it was a Java file, but there's a lot more. To get the actual JSON text from the file, we need to use the write method that returns the object and the applicable to JSON method, which will print the JSON string. Let's first run this to see how seamless it is. As you can see, the program ran and we have a completely new JSON string, which was printed through our Typesafe code. But there's more. We can now copy that JSON and try to parse it back to an object. I'm using the new Java text block syntax for strings, which I talked about in a previous video in the series. Notice that there are built-in APIs to read the JSON from files, URLs, etc. This is just more convenient and obvious for a demo. We can create a new JSON object using the load method, which, as I mentioned, includes all these various APIs to fetch JSON from various sources. But here is the really cool part. All of this doesn't just work for JSON. It works for comma separated values, also known as CSVs. It works for XML and YAML seamlessly. That means I can generate and parse any one of these formats with the exact same code, without writing any boilerplate code and without sacrificing type safety. When we run this code, we can see the YAML results right at the end. Notice it looks pretty close to the JSON results, and we didn't have to write any YAML code. The same is true for the XML code, which is pretty close as well, and surprisingly terse. CSV also works, but the format is a bit limited as it doesn't support nesting. So we can see where Manifold couldn't generate the right data in this case. I don't think this is a bug as much as it is an inherent limitation of CSV. But there are some limitations here. JSON is moving forward with standards like Schema. This is the schema from the Manifold Project GitHub page representing a user. I can just paste it next to the regular JSON file we have in the same directory. The schema describes a user object with a few fields and constraints. As such, it maps much better to a strict language like Java. We can now refresh Maven and go back to the code and see how the schema can significantly change things for us. We now have a new user object we can use just like the test object from before. The first thing to notice is that user's builder method accepts two arguments, the name and the email. Why is that? That's because the schema we have here defined these two arguments as required. So the builder method forces us to include them. If you ever used dates in JSON, then you know how terrible it is. Schema standardized dates, and this works rather nicely with Manifold, where we can use a local date instead of the typical weird hacks we need to use for JSON date and time. But it gets even better. The schema defined gender as either male or female. which on a personal note, I think is a bit limiting, but for demo purposes, it works. The enum type representing the options defined in the schema are available implicitly in code completion and work exactly as defined out of the box. I can also use static imports to make the code shorter if I choose to. Notice that all this translates and applies to other formats seamlessly. The point Manifold wants to highlight is that it literally compiles the JSON to Java bytecode and treats it as native IDE source code. Navigate to with control click goes to the right line in the right JSON file, since the file is a source file just like all the other source files. Everything is 100% up to date and seamless. I hope this video gave you a taste of what Manifold is about. It's a super exciting project, and I just touched the tip of the iceberg. In the next video, I will continue with it and show you some additional unexpected capabilities. Stay tuned. I'd love to hear about your experience and thoughts about Manifold. Sound off in the comments, and if you have any questions, please use the comment section. Thank you.